That's right, baby. That is how Daddy likes it.
Oh, yeah. Do it. So hot.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hump that money. Hump that money for me.
You like it when I hump my money, don't you?
So hot. Love it so much.
Oh, I know you like it. Oh, I'm close. I'm close.
Freeze.
Spin move.
Lester Keani, you're under arrest for embezzlement, racketeering, corruption, and a bunch of other rich guy crimes.
Ah, you pigs ain't got nothing on me!
No.
Ah.
But Sarah Stein does.
What? Read it and weep, Keani.
That muckraker!
Yeah, baby, I'm about to come.
I don't wanna be a robot, but I don't wanna die.
Hey, Sarah. How often do you use your computer?
Every day.
Okay, would it be possible to use it less, so instead of every day, we could do none of the days?
What? No. Why?
The budget for the small-town dispatch Picayune is being slashed again, so we gotta start selling off all our supplies.
Okay, let's not talk about that. Because Lester Chianti, remember him?
Yeah.
He's behind bars because of my article.
Oh my God, you've been going after that guy for months! Oh, congratulations, Sarah.
This is big because if you're going to steal money from millions of Americans, you're going to get what you deserve.
You're always fighting for the little guys. Oh, I am proud to call myself your editor-in-chief.
Yeah, I think that this is just the first of many, Joan. Yeah, I'm going to get all of those corrupt, powerful, greedy little bankers.
Get lost.
Fat cat CEOs.
Take a hike.
Old men humping piles of money in front of their niece.
What's that now?
Effective today, I am resigning from my position here at the small town dispatch Picayune, and I'm going to go after my lifelong dream of working for the Big City Times.
I don't know. What am I going to do without my best reporter? We're already hanging on by a thread as it is.
Joan, the Big City Times is the most influential paper in all of America. Plus, everybody knows that I'm just a big fish who's ready to leave her tiny pond.
We know that?
All those cable news companies think that they're the only ones that matter. But I know what matters is newspaper. Newspaper is coming back big, and I'm going to start a revolution.
I'm going to miss you, Sarah. Because you are the strongest woman and most tenacious reporter that I have ever met. So if you can take down Chianti, you can do anything.
I think if I keep going like this, I could probably win a Pulitzer.
Pulitzer. Hey, it doesn't matter. But you gotta find room for it here on your fancy wall, you know, next to your, college diploma?
Yeah.
Wow. What's that for?
Well, I went to college.
For what?
Journalism?
And I'm one of those.
You should.
Would you get it on the internet?
No, they mailed it to me.
They haven't mailed me one.
Thanks.
There's a war on our job creators, America. And it's led by muckraking hacks like Sarah Stein, here to join me tonight about how much she hates America. Sarah Stein!
Hi, I'm stupid Sarah Stein. I work in a dying industry. I'm a wimp, and I'd be an ISIS brat if they take me.
Holy! I'm gonna stop you right there. Now, Sarah, let me ask the question we've all been waiting to hear. What are you hiding?
My name is kinda Jewy, but how could you know for sure? Am I secretly a brown person?
I swear, if I have to defend us against another defamation suit because of this maniac, I will—
You'll what, Doug? You'll quit?
Maybe.
Well, you can't quit. You're fired.
What? No. My wife will kill me if I get fired again. I'll do anything.
You want your job back?
Yes, please.
Well, I can't really afford to hire anyone right now.
I'll take another pay cut.
$20,000.
$5,000?
$20,000.
$20,000.
Sit down.
Yes, ma'am.
I probably date smelly guys who, like, work for nonprofits and can't get boners.
still that look. I have an ulcer every time you get that look.
How many ulcers will you get when your family starves because you stood in my way? Oh. It's time for my first snake charming lesson. Let's go, Pink Lips.
Pink Lips? Oh, it's because I drink so much Pepto.
No.
Well, I can't read, but I heard you blew the lid off the Lester Chianti story. Pretty good work for a small town bumpkin. I'm impressed. You're hired.
Oh, wow. Really?
No, I'm sorry. I meant to put quotes around hired, but my hands are really cold at the moment, so I had them in
my
pockets. Okay,
I'm confused, so then I am hired?
You're not hired at all.
I'm really good.
The Big City Times is a high-pressure environment. We can't just have any old bumpkin come in off the street and start winning Pulitzer.
Pulitzers.
Pulitzer?
Pulitzer.
Pulitzer. What'd I say? Pulitzers?
Okay, you know what? No, this is what I'm supposed to be doing. I'm supposed to be working for the Big City Times, an influential paper, and covering big stories, and changing people's lives, and fighting for the little guy, and... Hello?
Sorry, I had to leave the room for a moment to get my muff. I figured you'd be gone by the time I got back, which clearly isn't the case.
Okay, you know what? This bumpkin's gonna leave your office in a second, but it's not the last you'll see of me. I'll be back, and you will remember my name.
No.
Cat Moondragon?
Owner and president of NNN. And this is our chief legal counsel for the network, Douglas Chips.
How do you do?
Sit.
Cool. So why did you kidnap me?
I love your work. The muckraking, the speaking truth to power, blah, blah, blah. I love it.
No, you don't.
I want you to work for me.
Your contract is all typed up and ready for you to sign. That's all right. We already signed it for you anyway.
No, I refuse to work for you people. You're everything that's wrong with journalism.
Sarah, people watch us. We're the number two cable news network in America, and with your help, we'll be number one.
No, because I like to report the news fairly and accurately, so that doesn't.
In a newspaper? Nobody watches newspapers. Do you know how many people watch our lead anchor, Bradley Chadwick Thompson V, every night? 3 million! And he's just a sharp haircut with the brain of a basset hound.
Actually, that dog turned out to be smarter, remember?
Right. Still, sharp haircut!
Cat, I refuse to debase myself with your cynicism.
Please?
Shut up! I can take no for an answer. How would you like the Big City Times?
What do you mean?
I own it. I just bought it.
No. I can't be bought, okay? I refuse to work for a network that has Evelyn Bastowich on it.
Ooh, good pun.
Thank you.
Great. Well, we have movers grabbing your stuff, and they'll be delivering it to your new office soon. Your first show starts in a couple hours. Good luck, because I will not settle for second place!
Hey, look, we just want to say welcome to the team, Sarah Stein. Thank you. This is both empty and open.
I needed a mixer for my scotch.
Bradley Chadwick Thompson V, up there, right it, do it, yes.
Nice, then you get to call me Brad Chad.
Evelyn, I don't know if you remember, but you called me a Jewy wimp.
Oh, that's right. That is water under the bridge.
No, that's not how it works. I have to forgive you.
Oh, thank you. That's very big of you.
I didn't forgive you.
Sarah, look, the deal is now we're a team.
That's really nice. That's great. But I do need you guys to get out of my office because I have to talk on TV in an hour and I haven't prepared what I'm going to say, and I'm freaking out about it.
I don't know. Look, you're thinking with your head. Think with your heart.
Some of us are journalists.
We're journalists.
Being on TV is fun.
You're overthinking it, girl. Look, this guy's been on TV every single night of the week during sweeps. Lost an IQ competition to a basset hound. I don't even think that's the smartest breed.
It's a dog.
All right, I've read some of your work and it's keen. You got this.
You called me stupid in front of a million people.
Since then, I have forgiven myself. Look, it's a crazy business. Crazy. But we're here for you, okay? Okay. If you need anything.
Okay.
This is a real quick thing.
Hey, Sarah.
Hey, Bridget.
You should go shopping with Evelyn sometime.
Why?
We're out of beer.
This is champagne.
King of beers.
Good evening, and welcome to Muckraker with Sarah Stein. I'm Sarah Stein, and tonight I am here to... Tonight, we are here to...
Listen to your heart.
To be honest, I don't really know why I'm here. Cable news has destroyed true journalism, which is the profession that I love, and a cornerstone of free society. America needs us, and the world needs us to be better. You know, ever since I was a little girl, I wanted to write for the newspaper to help people fight who couldn't fight for themselves. And after all this, I fear that I've sold my soul to the devil himself that is cable news. And I'd like you to keep that in mind as we move through our top stories tonight, America. Beginning with our top story...
Time's up.
Or rather, ending with... Thank you for tuning in. I'll see you next time. I'm Sarah Stein. Saying goodnight.
Hey!
Hi.
That was amazing.
Really?
Ah, so much honesty up there. The whole studio could learn from you.
Thank you.
You got it. You do.
Damn it.
Star is born.
You're a star that was born.
America. I'm just going to come right out and say it. Spineless, weak, and that skit. Jesus, that skit is not made for TV. Look.
She is pure evil.
We are proud. We're brave. We're free. Free voices, free speech, and this little Miss Journalistic Integrity, la 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 la, wants to tell us what to do, how to do it! Well, guess what, America? I want to hear what you have to say. The lines are open. Give us a call. Caller number one! You're on the air. I want you to tell me how Sarah Stein offends you the most.
Well, Evelyn, I just want less women telling me what to do.
I couldn't agree with you more. I don't think women should even vote. Gross.
How do you allow this?
It's good TV, Sarah. You could learn a lot from her.
Next caller!
That other lady said the thing that I like is bad. Is she right? I'm worried.
Can I ask you a question, caller?
Okay.
Are you American?
Yes, ma'am.
Then you have nothing to be afraid of, okay? We are brave and we are free and we are right. We are always right. They are always wrong. Red, white, and blue. And when I mean white, I mean right.
She's just pandering to the audience.
Next caller!
She's engaging in a conversation with her audience.
Papa Booey, Papa Booey.
Smartest thing I've heard in my life.
Come on!
All right, guys, looks like we need to take a small commercial break. When we get back, we're counting down the funniest photoshops of Sarah my viewers have sent in to EvelynBastovich.com. Don't you go nowhere.
Dumb shit gone nowhere. Dumb shit gone nowhere.
Hey, were you messing with me before about what you said about being there for me?
This is TV, babe.
Yeah, okay. Well, I bet you wouldn't be so tough if you came on my show. Muckraker with Sarah Stein, maybe you've heard of it.
I have. Is that so?
Yeah, it is so. So I'd love you to come on my show. We'll set things straight, and you can apologize to me in front of the whole country. How's that?
The second rule of television. A challenge made is a challenge accepted.
What's the first rule?
The first rule of television is you smell.
That's not a rule.
You stink.
Good evening, I'm Bradley Chadwick Thompson V, and you're watching American News Night. War in Canada and the search for our missing president all coming up, but first, our top story. Catfight! Ooh, baby, I'm excited. But how should you feel about it? For that, we turn to our panel of experts. Experts?
Sarah. Smart. Nice. Good.
Evelyn. Strong. Loud. Strong.
You heard it here first, America.
What are we doing about... She's not... She... Okay. Sure. Great. Good evening, I'm Sarah Stein, and welcome to Muckraker. Tonight, our top stories.
Thanks for having me on, Sarah.
And welcome to the program, Evelyn Bastovich. Thanks for coming on, Evelyn. Is there anything you'd like to say?
Thanks for having me on, Sarah.
No, something pertaining to what you said on national television, you know, in regards to my physical appearance.
I would do something about this hair.
Stop. I would like you to apologize on national television for inviting your idiot fan base to launch personal, hateful attacks on me.
Do you hear that, America? This East Coast elitist just called you all idiots.
And that's not what I was trying to say. What I was trying to say...
Oh, what are you trying to say? That you're all above this, Sarah? Do you think you can help save the world,
I know I can help Sarah. Save the world, Evelyn. I'm putting bad guys behind bars, and you feast on people's fears and insecurities, and it's infuriating.
You're fat.
You're fat.
No. I heard you the first time, and my response to that would be that I am appropriately sized for a woman who is 5'3" and just moved to a new city. Okay, we're not going to get a shred of decency out of Evelyn. Let's move into tonight's top stories.
Okay, then. Let's have some news, shall we? I have here, speaking of bad guys behind bars breaking, Lester Chianti has been released from jail. He got out on a technicality.
What are you talking about?
What I'm talking about, the cop didn't read him his Miranda rights. He simply stated, read him. And we.
It's ridiculous. I don't see that.
The report
here.
Just came in over the wire. You have the right to remain silent, Sarah.
You failed.
Oh no! I failed out with your people.
Oh no.
Oh no. That's a face for the newspapers only. Are you crying?
No.
Is that. Are you crying?
I don't cry.
Oh.
I'm angry.
Oh, I can tell. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back.
And maybe tomorrow night you can come on my show and apologize to me for wasting my time. Well... That's all the time we have for tonight. Thanks for joining us here on Muckraker with Sarah and Evelyn. And remember, America, bleed red.
The hell was that?
Good TV!
No, we need to talk about this, Evelyn.
Nope!
Spin move! It's me or her, sorry. That's good. It's me or it's her. It's me. Or it's
Kat wants you both in her office now.
Okay.
I hate snake charming! Those snakes can suck my dick!
As for you two, I will not be treated this way, okay? If it's me or it's her.
Evelyn! As of now, Bleed Red America, canceled.
I quit!
Thank you. Thank you.
Sarah, Muckraker, also canceled.
Thank you.
I want it
thank
to be, you. So I don't care.
You two will now permanently share a nightly debate show hosted by Brad Chat.
Oh, hell yeah.
Brad Chat, American News Night, also canceled.
Oh, sweet. Sweet, so I get to host a nightly talk show with these two fine-ass beauties.
Okay, I don't care if you own the big city news or whatever, but I'm just gonna leave and go back to my old paper, back where everything's nice and everything makes sense.
Oh, except your contract has a 10-year non-compete clause.
These ratings are killer. With you birds squawking at each other every night, we will finally be number one.
Oh, I had a great time. Yeah, I could do this every night. Yeah, I'm in.
This is a nightmare. No, Sarah, wake up.
Great!
Sarah, wake up.
Well,
wake
up. We just need a name for the show.
I got one. Evelyn Bastovich presents The Debate Room 360 at NNN.
You're welcome. Or The Heat Seat with Two Hot Ass Bitches.
You have 24 hours to come up with a new name for a new show.
We just came up with a bunch of names just now.
First place, or I'll kill you. Get out.
Death frightens me. What else you been up to?
Sarah!
Hey, Joan.
Sarah!
What are you doing out here?
Oh gosh. More budget cuts, Sarah. We were evicted. And by we, I mean I, because everybody else was laid off.
That's horrible. I'm so sorry.
No, that's okay. Look, I'm still putting out the paper every day. Better than ever. No, wait. What are you doing here?
I came to maybe get my old job back.
No. You're a big TV star now.
I can't go back to NNN because it's full of, you know, sociopaths and lunatics and handsome bassinounds, and I don't belong there, so I'm gonna come back here.
Yes, you do. Hey, remember that first day when the business bureau chief screamed at you for stinking up the break room microwave with your Gordon's brand frozen fish sandwich?
It's the worst day of my life. And yes, I cried in your office for 3.5 hours, so I remember. Yeah.
Then, you got tough.
Yeah, you're right, I did. He dug through his tax records, and they found that he hadn't filed in 15 years.
Lost his house.
And now he lives in a split level in the fish sandwich district, so it's pretty cool.
Sarah, you can't work here. This place is dead. Newspaper is dead. The only way you're going to do what you want to do is by going back to NNN.
I know you're right. I just... Okay. All right, yeah. I got to go back to NNN, and I'm going to do my job, and I'm going to do it well.
Okay, see you later. Do you want to see my second edition?
She doesn't care.
I already said that I was coming back. Jesus. Douglas.
Who is Douglas? This is the Iceman.
What are you talking about? Why are you wearing an eye patch?
This eye patch was medically prescribed to the Iceman for medical reasons. All right. Jeez. You really are as good as they say. Listen, you have to come back to NNN. Us sane people have to stick together, all right?
Okay. Sure thing. Can I just sit in the front seat, please?
No. It's safe to ride shotgun with the Iceman?
Of course it's not.
How did you know it was me?
Hacking into Sarah's computer. Doesn't know I'm here.
Brad Chad.
Hey, Sarah. Hey, why don't you show me some skin, huh?
I'm not showing you any skin.
No? Oh, shit, sorry.
Who did it?
Don't. Please. Please get out of my office.
Must be moved.
Give me all the dirt you got on Lester Chianti. No, now!
Follow the money.
This whole thing pertains to money. Do you have anything more specific?
The gardener always protects his lambs.
What are you talking about?
The pink lady sleeps with the dove.
Oh, see, I heard the pink dove sleeps with the lady.
Really?
Yeah, and that sometimes the farmer's the first one to lay the egg.
Who told you that?
Nobody told me that. I made it up. Weird idiot. Thanks for wasting my time.
Hi, I'm Lester Chianti's accountant. Are you Sarah Stein?
I'm she. Hello.
These are his complete financial documents. I wanted to give them to a reputable reporter, and I heard you're the best.
You did. That's because that is a correct statement. Okay, so then you're his accountant. Why did you give me the documents?
Lester betrayed me. He was one of the only people I shared my prog rock band's concept album with, Moonchild Falls to Earth. He laughed right in my face. Also, he stole all my money, and that's pretty embarrassing for an accountant.
Hold on. What's Evelyn's name doing in here?
Evelyn Bastovich? Well, that's one of his biggest partners.
Do you have more stuff on her?
I can check.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good evening, America, and welcome to cable television's hottest new debate show. I'm Bradley Chadwick Thompson V. With me is Evelyn Baskovich and Sarah Stein.
Hello.
Hi.
Tonight we analyze some hot topics in today's news.
Hey, let's talk about Sarah.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yes, Brad Chad.
Yeah, she's been out of booze since this morning and has done nothing about it.
Well, that is an excellent point. Sarah, why do you hate us so much?
Screw this.
Oh, wow, on television. Everyone. Wow.
We can believe that.
Do you know there's computers?
Breaking news. As previously reported by me, billionaire investor Lester Chianti has drained the pension funds of countless prominent businesses. And according to my sources, he has shared those stolen funds with none other than her. How's it feel to be exposed, Evelyn?
She's done worse.
I've done worse. Do you guys not care about anything at all?
Stop. It doesn't matter. It will never matter. What you do and work for is stupid.
It does matter. What we do here does matter because people listen to us and people need us. You'll see.
Is that a challenge?
Yeah, it is.
Challenge made.
Is a challenge accepted?
This is good TV.
Coming up, the mysterious hobo strangler is America's newest serial killer. But is he single? We'll be right back. I don't wanna be a robot.
Car matching this description was involved in a recent series of broad daylight kidnappings.
You wouldn't happen to know anything about that, would you?
What? No, I don't even own a black bag. Now that I think about it, the suspect has an eye patch. It doesn't look anything like this guy.
Yeah, you're right. Sorry for bothering you, sir. Good night.
It's okay. Whew. Spin move.
All right, everybody. Buckle up.